RBL Bank reported a drop in its net profits by 69%, its net interest income went up, however, by 41%. One of the main highlights in the earnings was the asset quality. The ratios continue to inch up. Gross NPAs coming in at 3.33% versus 2.6% on a sequential basis, and slippages continue to remain elevated. The MD and CEO of the bank, Mr. Vishwa Veer Ahuja, is here to talk to us about the earnings. Mr. Ahuja, so one of the main highlights of the earnings is the slippages figure, which continues to remain elevated. And two quarters back, you had guided us that this might show up in the corporate book. So could you talk to us about what were the factors, which were the main accounts, and what led to this pressure as far as the asset quality is concerned?
No, actually, the position is improving from the point of view of the fact that there is nothing new that has happened as far as your question is concerned. I mean, the concerns on asset quality were around a few set of corporate accounts which were, you know, identified, you know, two quarters ago, and a certain amount of, if I may say, potential stress in that portfolio was identified and sized. And we had put out that number, and we had said that over 2 to 3 quarters, this portfolio will have to be, you know, accounted for in terms of NPA and provisioning. So that number has not changed. And the good thing is that even though the broader economic environment, and particularly in the corporate sector, continues to be vitiated, and many new stress names have come up, you know, in the banking system, for us, fortunately, you know, we don't have any of those newer names, so to say, associated with us. So in our case, we are just dealing with addressing a certain situation which we have already talked about and, you know, put out in the public domain, and we are basically going through the motions of basically taking care of that. Apart from that, the business of the bank continues to operate on a very healthy footing. It is not only business as usual, but we are seeing healthy growth across businesses. As you would have noted, we have grown in advances by over 20%. We have grown in deposits. We've grown in CASA by more than 31%. We've grown in operating profits by more than 47% year on year. And we've reduced cost income ratio. We have, you know, our net interest margins are at an all-time high of 4.57%. And therefore, in every respect, the franchise is performing extremely well. Our retail growth was 42% year on year. So, you know, frankly speaking, but for something that has already been identified and ring-fenced, and we are just dealing with that, there has not been any new material development on the adverse side. If anything, things are going well. As far as cards business is concerned, it hit and crossed a milestone of 2.5 million cards. Our card spends are among the best in the industry. We are gaining in market position, you know, every quarter. And as far as the rest of the retail business is concerned, it is also doing extremely well. And if you look at bureau reports, or as we do our own portfolio reviews, we have not seen any stress build up in that entire retail portfolio, and it remains stable. So, I mean, if anything, I would say that I'm very satisfied with where we stand in terms of the improving franchise strength of the bank. And in terms of the legacy issues, this is the fourth quarter of this fiscal year. There is a tail left to be provided for. Bulk of the provisioning is already done. And we will hit the new year on a very normalized BAU fashion with healthy growth and a very strong franchise.
So, Mr. Ahuja, that watch list that you had told us earlier, 1800 crores, so you're saying that there is absolutely no change in that. And I understand out of that 1800 crores, you've said in the con call that in Q2 and Q3, 1500 crores has slipped and just 300 crores is left. So is that correct? And also, sir, how is the traction in your BB and BBB below book? And what percentage of those books generally, you know, in your observations are at the risk of slipping?
Yeah. So no, this is a very good question. As far as your first part of the question is concerned, yes, you're right. We had indicated a number of 1800 crores. We are still tracking to that number, more or less. 1500 crores have been taken and the balance is available to us from the point of view of guidance. We don't see any reason to change that guidance. That's the first part. The second part of your question is that our BB book and BB plus and below book is approximately 6%, and it has been at that level more or less, you know, for the last 1, 2, 3 quarters. And there is, in fact, this book is stable at that level. We don't see any striking correlation of delinquencies that tend to happen from that book. If anything, I would comment that this 1800 crore specific stress of a significant nature that came up all came from advances book, which was all rated A and AA and better. So, I mean, at the end of the day, the BB position has remained more or less stable and not caused beyond the normal sort of BAU level of slippages or NPAs, and the, you know, the trouble actually came from a very different space. So that's how I would address your question. Outside of this 1800 crore number, I think our overall book, asset book or advances book, is in healthy shape, and as I just commented, on the corporate wholesale side, we've already sized and identified the problem. On the rest of our wholesale book, we are making all attempts to further granularize that portfolio and tighten the underwriting standards more and more going into the future, so that such episodes don't repeat themselves. And therefore, we are very tightly managing that book. On the consumer retail side, I already commented that we have a very stable risk portfolio. So, I would say that, you know, we are in a fairly good position as far as the future is concerned.
So I want to talk a bit about the retail book. You're saying that you are not seeing any sort of stress build up in that particular book, but most of the other private banks who have reported the earnings so far, they have seen some rise in delinquencies. Most of them are saying that they've become more alert. So how are you seeing the environment currently, and how are you managing it?
So certainly we are also more alert. I mean, I must start by saying that the environment itself has seen certain challenges and certain, if I may say, disruptions. I mean, the fear is that if the economy remains very slow and sluggish, you know, it could lead to job losses and stuff like that, and that can have an impact on the so-called salaried segment. So, you know, and you know, at the end of the day, we do have credit cards and others out to that segment too. So therefore, I think the main thing to say here is that, you know, you need to really tighten and strengthen the underwriting standards on a very dynamic and ongoing basis, which is something that we have done. And the fact is that we start taking very, very swift decisions whenever we see even the slightest bit of stress build up. So either we shut a tap off, or we, you know, bring it down, or we do something to make sure that on a portfolio basis, you know, we don't deviate from the acceptable levels of risk benchmarks that we have set. So that's where I'm saying that we are also constantly, you know, monitoring the environment, and on a proactive basis tweaking our filters such that, you know, we don't see a material deterioration in the portfolio.
Okay. Sir, just one last question. So your loan book has grown 21% this time, deposits, loan growth 20%, deposits 21%. So what kind of momentum do you see going ahead? And there's a lot of, you know, fanfare right now about the credit cards business in general. So how much would be the traction in that going forward?
So the loan growth at 20% reflected a flattish and very muted growth on the corporate wholesale side, which is a deliberate, if I may say, strategy for the time being. We don't want to take inordinate risks in that space. We have been paring down exposures in that space, like I said, to further granularize that portfolio and to operate at much tighter underwriting standards to make sure there is no repeat of the past. So that's the one thing. So our growth is essentially for the time being coming from the retail side, which, as you have noted, grew more than 40% year on year. And in that space, all our segments are growing handsomely. All taken together, we expect to grow at the mid-20s, because some amount of corporate wholesale growth will come back in the next few months. And we expect to definitely, you know, take advantage of the opportunities, because we are very, very well positioned as a bank in the corporate segment also. And we have a very good standing profile and reputation. And we have all the bouquet of products and services available, and a fairly sizable and healthy capital position and balance sheet. So there is, and the relationships that are required. So what I'm trying to say is that we are targeting a mid-20s growth next year, and hopefully for the next 3 years or so. And for that, we have raised enough capital. So we did a capital raise of 2,700+ crores. That has put us in a situation where we can grow at this rate for the next 3 years.
All right, sir. We really hope that happens. So thank you so much for joining us, and all the best, sir.